You've been a dirty girl. It's time for you to get cleaned up. Get it? Because the gun's dirty and I'm going to clean it. Just roll the intro.
Hey, y'all. Luke the Rebel out here doing some fishing today. So, I know where I come from. How about you? I don't need baggy clothes or rings in my nose to be cool.
Here's the trick. Put them on the ground like this.
The scars on my knuckles match the scuffs on these cowboy boots. And there's a whole lot more like me. How about you?
Hey, y'all. Luke the Rebel back with another video for y'all. How y'all doing? I think we're up to 32 subscribers on this channel, if I'm not mistaken. So, thank y'all. Be sure to hit that subscribe button. So, went shooting the other day and, haven't got around to cleaning my 22 here. So, figured I would, go ahead and, clean it for you guys. Show you how to clean my guns. Clean cylinder. This is a 8-shot 22 Arminius. If you don't know anything about Arminius, Arminius is a German company from early 1900s. And so, yeah. Alright, so first thing that I like, first thing is I use REM oil. Reason I use REM oil is because, like, I know a lot of people like hops and stuff like that, but hops is really expensive, and I don't know, I've always used REM oil as long as I've been shooting, so, and it is a CLP, which cleans, lubricates, and protects, so, good stuff. Alright, so, first thing I like to do is go straight for the cylinder, so, I go ahead and nice and just spray the crap out of it. So there's that, let that seep down just a little bit. Also, something you want to have is like an old shirt, which is what this is on, and another rag to wipe away excess and to dry it off. Okay, so go ahead and clean that. Just want to make sure you get every hole. So, next we're gonna do is clean the side of the cylinder. Right, so I think I'm gonna go ahead and clean the barrel now. So what I like to do when I clean the barrel is I like to take a rag and put it in here so it doesn't spray out everywhere. So let's go ahead and do that. That drain down for a minute. Okay. Always go, try to go with the rifling of your barrel when you clean the barrel out. That way you don't mess anything up in there. Scratch the barrel up or anything like that. Alright, next, see, in there can get pretty dirty. So, at this point, I just like to spray the crap out of it and basically act like I'm brushing my teeth. I like my guns clean. And also, some people don't clean after every use. I do. Yeah, see, look how dirty that was. 22s actually get really dirty. If you don't know that about 22s, because more of the actual round shaves off when it shoots for some reason. I don't know exactly why it does that. But it does. I know that. I've always heard that 22s get a lot dirtier than most guns. So. And as far as the brand Arminius goes, I've heard a couple people say that, like, put it down and everything, but I've never had a problem with, this particular, 22 caliber revolver, 8-shot revolver. I mean, it shoots good. I've never had any mechanical problems with it. It has all its original pieces as far as I know, and I have no idea how old this gun is. Because it was actually passed down to me from my grandpa, and he bought it at a gun shop, so, and it was used, so he's not sure how old it is either. But, got my first gun, and this is it. I was 14. Passing it down the family, which is why this is very special to me. I'll always have this, because my grandpa gave it to me. If you guys have any, firearms are passed down to you, go ahead and comment down below and let me know what you got. It's always good to hear about that. Which is why I'm actually against registering guns, because if you do that, there's no more passing down guns in the family, and that's something that a lot of fathers and grandfathers like to do with their kids and grandkids, you know? Because they want to give them something that's important to them, so... And it does have a decocker, if you didn't notice that. Alright, so now, what you want to do is... What I like to do is take the brush off. And then go into here, and get this piece. Throw that on there. Make sure, is this the right size? Yeah, it's the right size, okay. And then you get one of these. Oh. Got no scissors or nothing. Oh well. You wanna kind of fold it to where it will fit through here. Put it in just like that. Make sure that I usually cut these, so I'm gonna make sure that it will. Okay, yeah, it's gonna fit. All right. Typically, what I like to do with the first one is check to see or whatever brand you like to use. And at this point, what I like to do is unscrew the spray bottle with my rum oil. That's why it's good to have a rag, because you have somewhere to set this down now. I like to dip this inside here. Screw the spray thing back on. And then this is going to help us clean in the crevices just a little bit better. And this used to be white. Yeah. Nice and dirty. Okay. So now I'm going to take the other half of what we cut earlier. And put it through. Pull it. Now we're going to do this dry and hopefully it'll be cleaned up enough. Alright. Now, as you can see, it's not as clean as we'd like it to be, but I'm just going to call it quit on the cylinder right now, because the cylinder honestly is not as important to be clean as the barrel is. So cylinder clean enough for me for now. Same thing, we fold it, put it through, go to our barrel, there we go, perfect. Barrel is actually pretty clean. You can see that. It's almost perfectly white, in fact. Nice. Alright, so got that out of the way. Now I'm going to take my other half of my patch, and I'm going to wipe inside the frame just to see if I've missed any spots. Maybe even outside the frame by the hammer. And seems to be pretty clean. Alright. So now what I'm going to do is just make sure everything is nice and dry. Just dry everything here. Alright, so I'm still just drying this. Make sure it's nice and... Let me see if I can see inside there. That'll focus. You can basically see that it's pretty clean for the most part anyway. Last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to lube my extractor rod. So I'm going to get my oil. I'm going to push it up and squirt a little spray. There we go. Make sure that push it a few times, make sure it gets nice and lubed. Cause this gun, being its age, actually has a pretty, it's pretty tough to extract. Which is to be expected in old guns. It's not at the point where it needs a new extractor rod. But yeah, alright. So gotta dry everything off again. And for the most part, got a clean gun there. Just wanted to show y'all how I clean my gun, and that's pretty much what I do every time. It's tedious, takes a little while, but it's worth it to have a clean gun. Let me know what you guys use, and be sure to like, comment, subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you next time. Bye.